Come on. What a piece of junk.
I haven't heard Matthew on comms yet.
He don't want to hear, want us to hear all his cussing bouncing off these walls.
Hey, David, sorry I didn't get a chance to put any setup in our file.
Hey, no problem, Paul. I'm just now kind of getting my first laps here anyway. I'm just using the same one from last week. Is that what you're doing?
No, I worked on it a little bit. Can we transfer them
yeah.
in the game?
Send it to me in the game.
Okay, I'll do that.
I think you can. I'm not sure how to do it, but somebody
do it with the share. Click on share and then click on David's name.
Thanks, Norm. And then I think it goes, where does it go from me?
Into your received folder.
Okay. Yeah,
hello, everybody.
You have to refresh.
There you are.
Back in the track.
Yes, I got it.
For some reason, I was out. So please, Daryl and Ryan, please escape to the pit. And Johnny, please back in. Thank you.
Thanks, actually, everybody. I did not get it, Paul, so you might try to send it one more time.
Okay. Yes. Sorry about that, guys. I don't know. I just realized that my mic was not playing games, or it was playing games, so there we are.
David, you have to refresh so that rFactor2 reads
the file. So everybody, just a few minutes here. We'll go through the race brief really quickly. Super to see so many people out tonight on such an entertaining track. Glad everyone's here for our round 8 of 10. Only two more to go. And the races are pretty tight all around for stuff going on. So really pleased to have a good crowd out here. Entertaining place. So as usual, we've got a 60-minute race. We have a, I think I put 20 minutes in for the quali. A little extra time because it's a bit longer lap and people could screw up. And then we're off and running. So as usual, during the race and the quali, please, everyone either on muted mic or push to talk or voice activation that doesn't
think I can manage
generate random noises. And that should have been a clue for me because my mic was open and no one was saying anything for a while, so it should have been a clue. I think everyone should be familiar with the starting procedure. A little bit of a change today is that we head off and we get the start from the race, except that, of course, we're just going around on a pace lap. Even though it counts as a race lap, we're just doing the pace lap in pairs. Once we move off and get around to T1, you can shake out into single file. And then when we're back down on the Conroad Straight, heading down towards the chase, if you'd please start moving back into pairs. The pole sitter will have to be attentive to that and just dawdle his way down the Conroad Straight so everyone can catch back up again, so that by the time we get down to the final corner and on the start-finish straight, everyone's back up in pairs and we can make a good start. So as you're going along, whether you're in pairs or you're in single file, keep about a car's length or so between you and the next car. No sudden acceleration, weaving, or hard braking. We just want to get through the lap nice and easy, get ourselves into formation for a rolling start. You can drag brakes as long as you maintain a consistent speed and don't goof people up around you. The pole sitter can move faster than 100 kilometers an hour in some areas if it's nice and clear. But just remember, as you come to corners, slow down slowly so it's not you're not creating an accordion and that people can react behind you. it's up to you to manage the packs, make sure you can see what's going on behind you. Once we're in the final corner and heading along the start-finish line, everyone should be in pairs. Like I said, a car length behind, and then the race for each pair starts at the start-finish line. No passing, no acceleration prior to that point. And once you hit the start-finish line, your race starts. And a reminder, because it could happen this track, if you have an off track or otherwise lose your place during the formation, let the field carry on and join the back. Do not attempt to force your way back up along to your position. Just go to the back, accept that you're now wearing the Lantern Rouge, and the gap will be reconstructed by the cars that are ahead of you. So just know where you're supposed to be, left or right, and line up, and just pay attention to who's ahead of you when you start off, so you can maintain that gap when you get back into pairs. The orange zone is from the start finish to T19, which is getting out of the S's and heading down the Conrad Straight for the first lap. And then for every lap thereafter, basically from the cut through to the S's, is going to be an OZ for the entire race. That's a pretty tricky area, so heading up, did I say that right? No, sorry, heading down the S's. So once you hit the crest, that skyline, and start coming down the S's, that is now an orange zone. So it's from 1 to 19, which is all the way around the mountain before you hit the Conrad Straight. And then for the remainder of the race, it's 11 to 19. Wiggling your way back down the mountain before you clear up on the Conrad Straight. That is going to be an orange zone for the entire race. And from the start until turn 19 is for the first lap. So it doesn't mean you can't race in that area, either on the first lap or any succeeding lap, but just be aware that it is a dangerous sector. If you cause an incident in trying to pass, or you're otherwise a little bit goofy and you get an IRR against you, stewards feel it's your fault, you're going to be paying a more heavy penalty. So just, it's an hour-long race. We got plenty of time to make passes. It's an area where it can easily get bogged up quickly, because even though the yellow flags are out there and people do need to pay attention, particularly for this race, especially in that area of the mountain, it can jam up the track completely very quickly, and it ruins a lot of people's races. So just be competitive, but be smart when you're going through the orange zone. We've got some penalties. They're still hanging on. I don't see anyone here that has a penalty from previous races, but so that shouldn't be a problem. Just remember, when you get RF2 penalties, you'll have to serve them as normal. If you're DQ'd, you're DQ'd. Blue flag, very important for every race, more so for this one. You can't compete with or obstruct the lapping car. You have to make, you just follow your line, run your race. The car that is making the pass has to do so cleanly and safely, and both have responsibility for good racing behavior. So respect each other's race. Realize that going through the orange zone throughout the race is going to be a really difficult place to make a pass if something goes wrong for either driver. And if you're passing a lapped car, it's probably something's gone wrong for them.
I mean, the whole race
not going
is
well. So it's going to be a high risk time to pass there. So just pick your time and place and make it cleanly. Track limits haven't been a problem on this track. Remember that it's one wheel on the racing surface all the time. Pay a lot of attention when you're cresting the mountain and then on through the descent of the S's. It's easy to have problems there as the car is shifting around a lot and you're going from pounding it up the hill to trying to keep the brakes, you know, keep yourself from rolling into the walls going down. Pit entry, as you come down to pit entry, make sure you set up well to the left if you have to go in the pit. And enter at the beginning of the pit lane, get off the racing surface as quickly as possible. Remember the corner coming in. And on pit exit, it's really short. So make sure you stay left, integrate into the left side of the racing surface as late as you can. And then don't start moving around until you need to. And really, if you're coming in on the left, you're going to be wanting to set up on the left way, way, way down the straight anyway. Your decision for pitting. In the case of an incident, if you're in a particularly tight area, just a quick message on the voice chat here that something's going on. People should see the yellow flags, but just a quick safety thing if you can get that out. Otherwise, if you've caused a problem to someone else and you can give back the position, please do so in a safe place so they can get back onto racing. And if you really have a problem with what someone's done and you're upset, you're not able to resolve it after the race, just you know the IRR process and away you go. I think everyone's familiar with what escape means for your race. So you either use the control alt delete or unplug your network cable, allow rF2 to go weird or restart it, and then plug in your network cable or and or rejoin. You'll be a couple laps down, but you can see what's happened to your car and figure out what you can do from there. And you can still race for points. We will do a pit box check at the start of warm-up. So everyone knows that. Just click drive, come out of your box, get to come out of your garage, get to your pit box. Just pay attention to where it is and drive forward or backwards to get into it rather than doing a full lap, please, if you can at all.
203.
Make sure you're on the left side of the pit box when you get in there in case someone else sees me. And apart from that, should be a lot of fun. Have we got any questions? Great. Then I will move the session forward, and we'll get out there for the quali. Have a good time out there, everybody. And be safe.
20 minutes on this fuel. That's 22 minutes of fuel.
Good luck, everyone.
Oh, here we go.
Good luck, all.
This is not quali.
Lots of room on the track, so and lots of time, so people can spread out a little bit. Smart cue.
That's the end of the session. P8.
And thank you for putting up the stream, Ross. Appreciate it.
There we go. Getting ready for qualifying. Just waiting for it to officially kick over. There it is.
Exit's clear. Don't cross the white line.
Okay, Eric.
We've got 19 minutes to get a decent lap in. Your brakes are cold. We need to get some heat into them. Yellow flag. Keep your wits about you, mate. Sector 1 is clear. Left side, clear left. Car right, clear on your right.
About Brent Kesby, he is absolutely blisteringly fast, but Bowers is ahead of him. Bowers is not usually blisteringly fast, so we may both catch him.
Alexander on the flying lap.
All right. All clear on the right.
That's a new fastest lap for Tonk, 206.1. Sector 3 time is fast. Sector 1 is yellow. Okay, Eric, 15 minutes left. That's 15 minutes. Sector 1 is 0.8 off the pace.
Nice.
Yellow flag, Sector 2. Sector 2 is green.
Estimated 207. Oh, very low. Okay. It's better. Faster. That's what we want, quality.
P5. You need to find a 10th in Sector 3. The guy behind has just done a 206.9. Sector 1 is 0.3, off the pace. Sector 3 is now yellow. It looks like Struha has crashed. Green flag Sector 3. Sector 2 is 0.5 off the pace.
Sector 1 was blazing fast, but then I lifted a little bit. Now the tires are really jacked up, so we'll see what we can do here.
Air temp rising, it's now 75 Fahrenheit. P4. Sector 1 is now green.
Do one more lap on these tires.
Yellow flag. Yellow flag in sector 2. Right, Eric, 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left. Forget about that. It'll probably just polish out.
Oh man, this is pretty good quality.
There's a car approaching. Don't cross the white line. Watch your mirrors. Blue flag.
On your right. Clear right.
Green flag, sector 1. There's a faster car approaching. Green flag, sector 2. Sector 1, yellow flag. We think Kruger has stacked it. Sector 1 is green.
What? I was like 4th and now 7th.
Yellow flag. I think P3's been dead. Sector 3 is clear. P7.
Jeez. I need a 205.
Sector 2 is now yellow. Sector 1 is 0.8 off the pace. Sector 2 is now green. Okay, Eric, 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes left. Sector 3 time is fast. Sector 1 is 0.8 off the pace.
Oh, but look at the first sector.
Sixth place.
Ah, yeah.
Yellow flag, sector 2. We think that Kelly has gone off. Green flag in sector 2. Just 2 minutes left, 2 minutes to go. You're a second off in sector 1. The leader's just done a 203.4. Sector 2 is 1.2 off the pace. Incident in Sector 1. Sector 1 is yellow. We can see Gutierrez has binned it. Green flag, Sector 1.
Got into the 205s. That's amazing for me.
first lap.
Yellow flag, watch out. That's the end of the session, B6.
Might eke out Ibby. Just maybe. Concentrate. I beat Ibby.
Look at that qualifying result, P5.
All right, looks like everybody is done. Nice racing there out from Daniel Tick Bull at 0334, Ben Pro-Am at 0342, and our top AM is Alexander at 207.67. So some interesting laps out there. I saw some argy bargy going on. Remember that quali is also open for people to point out to the stewards when things aren't done well, and I saw a few things out there, so you may have cause. And then really nicely done, guys. So make sure you've got yourself all set up with your racing setup as opposed to your queue if you do make changes. And as we go to the drive, which we are now, let's go for a pit box check, please.
Okay, back to practice for the pit box check.
Okay, pit stop requested.
Of course, if I went the right way out of the pit, that would work out a whole lot better, too.
Was that you?
Yeah, I decided I could leave the pit and go the other direction. Decided that driving this track the other direction would be a lot more exciting. And I think Carl might be of the same mind.
Pit crew is ready.
Am I bet?
Yeah, I am.
Is this your pit box? No, it's not.
Yeah, it was, but
okay,
yeah,
I
was
sharing.
Going the wrong direction. Yeah, yeah.
You guys confused
who's,
me.
Who's number 35?
Yeah. Sorry about that.
I'm beside 24, it looks like.
Yeah, that's me, Eric. Who's 35?
Right. Well, I'll get you out. I'll let you out.
The track temperature's rising.
Well,
it's 83 Fahrenheit.
We're sharing. We know what we need to know, don't we?
All right. Well, as long as you don't feel the urge to go out and actually physically verify, that's fine by me.
Yeah, well, I did, but I was pointing the wrong direction.
Yeah, that was very cool. How's everybody doing out there? Got everybody out yet? Is everyone doing their stuff? Anyone that is still in the pit box yet? Or still in their garage? Everyone's out of the garage. There's a few people that are...
Ross, is that you next to me?
Katera, is you and I or Sharon?
No, it's Sean Kelly.
In the cellar.
Oh, okay. Okay, well, if everyone's out of the garage, no one said they're not. Everything looks to be good, so you've got a few minutes to get yourself shut back in, and we will go at 10 minutes, everybody. Or, sorry, at the end of the 10 minutes.
The pit exit's clear. Your brakes are cold. Be careful.
Alright, now we got full car fuel for the practice. Got to relearn all our braking zones. Wait, are we not using the whole time, or are we using only 5 minutes more?
No, we're using 10 minutes of the warm-up, the full warm-up, and then 5 minutes is the outlap. I don't know if that's necessarily the case.
Incident in Sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. I think P4's gone off.
I'm with Sean. We've got the tires. We keep playing pinball off the doors.
Got a little excited there.
It's going to be a fun race.
Oh boy.
Sector 3 is green. That's 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes.
Picking up other people's debris, that's what it is.
Fastest lap for Chen, 207.5. Yellow flag in Sector 1, P3. Sector 3 is 0.5 off the pace.
One more lap, don't check fuel.
The guy behind has just done a 209.1. Sector 1 is clear.
Wow, I can run a 206 with a full tank. Alright, what do we got here? 65 minutes should be enough fuel, but just for shits and giggles, I will go up
2 minutes to go, 2 minutes. The leader has just done a 206.0.
That better be enough.
Paul.
The car sorry, ahead has just done a 207.6.
Yeah, that's why.
I won't do that in the race, don't worry.
Oh boy, here we go. Alrighty. We'll see what we can do here. See if we can make it work.
That's the end of the session, P4.
Okay, everybody. Let's make sure your setups are good and your mics are set up and you're all set for a good hour's worth of racing.
Okie dokie, here we go.
So race one is only 30 minutes.
Nice try, my friend. Nice try.
P5. The track temp is 72. The air temp is 70 Fahrenheit. Okay, pit stop requested.
Yeah, we only need
don't
seven
spot.
Right?
All right, exactly.
Peace. Turn off the spotter.
More
for
than
the
enough.
Formation lap.
For some, yes. For some, far too much.
Pit stop. Clear fuel.
Okay, no refueling this time.
Oh, it does that when I have zero.
And that's 30 seconds.
Zero pit stops, but we shall see.
Good luck, guys.
Move.
Good luck, everybody.
Move the
these displays around a little bit real quick.
Remember, for this pace lap, it's no problem stringing out into single file. But when we hit the Conrad, back to normal, everybody. Make sure you know what your position is.
Go! Understood. We're not going to change the tires this time round. Yellow flag. Sector 1 is green.
There's some sand in your eye, Gio.
Huh? What did you say, Norm?
Never mind.
I'm gonna figure out how to turn down your mic there, Gio. My lord.
Yellow flag, sector 1.
Good, everybody. How's it in the back? Good.
Still sorting out.
All right.
We're doing okay back here, I think.
Yeah, we're good now.
All right.
Yellow flag in sector 3. Sector 3 is now clear.
Good luck, everybody.
Oh god, here we go.
B5.
Spot on.
This spotter is available. The gap ahead is now 0.6. Race has retired. The leader has just done a 205.4. That's your best lap in this session. All right, Eric, this bastard's holding you up. You've got to find a way past. Front is now 0.9.
has just done a 205.0. That last lap was a 207.8. Chen behind is now 1.0. It's fine, mate. It's just a scrape. These guys are faster. Max walking away, and Jerry's catching up ever so slightly. Up in front is now 1.5 seconds. Yellow flag sector 2. We think Tong has crashed. Slower class car ahead.
Is it?
I did the same thing Mac did.
Thank you.
front is now 1.0 seconds. Okay, Eric, that's good consistency. Keep it up.
I will take uneventful.
Green flag in sector 2. The gap to Jen behind is now 1.3 seconds. P4.
Front's trashed.
We think luck has stacked it. Sector 1 is now green.
Like me.
Thank you. GT3.
I will take a podium. I just chill.
The gap to Chen behind is now 0.8. Overton is now retired. You've just done a 208.2. Sector 1 is yellow.
Jerry's 10th faster.
So Chen behind is now 0.6.
I need driver left.
Green flag sector 1. Ignore that fucker in the mirror. Stick to your line. Nail those exits. Incident in sector one, yellow flag.
Pretty sure Jerry's gonna catch me.
That lap time was 208.2. Lap times are pretty consistent. Green flag, sector one. Yellow flag. It looks like Overton has gone off. Flag in sector three. It looks like Kruger has spun off. Sector three is clear. Green flag. P2.
Last corner of Essence.
On the outside of the last corner for the Conrad.
Front is increasing, it's now 5.5.
I'm okay with the gap in front increasing, as long as the gap behind it keeps increasing as well.
Green flag, sector 2.
But I'll also take P2.
So Chen behind is increasing. It's now 1.5. Still be faster than Jerry.
Yeah.
okay, Eric. You're halfway home. Got plenty of fuel.
Halfway home sounds good. I like that.
Incident in sector 2, yellow flag. We think that Kelly has pinned it. Sector 2 is clear. Gap to Chen behind is now 1.0 seconds. Yellow flag in sector 1. V3 has gone off. Yellow flag. Flag in sector 1. Slower class car ahead.
Car on your right. Clear on your right.
The actor Chen behind is now 2.8 seconds. Green flag in sector 3. Alright, Eric, you've used half your fuel.
On your right. They're on your right.
The gap in front has increased to 6.2 seconds.
Take a P2. The gap behind is now 5.4 seconds. Thank you.
You've just done a 208.2. The gap ahead is now 6.2. It's been a very intense race. Lots of focus. Yellow flag in sector one. Sector one is green. We think that Struha has stacked it. That's 20 minutes to go. 20 minutes.
Closed a little bit on Mac. I don't know if I'll be able to pick it up.
Okay, Eric, you're gaining on the guy in front. The gap is 5.0. Incident in sector 2, yellow flag. Looks like Kelly has spun off.
Left side of S's.
The gap behind has now decreased to 4.6. Kelly has just retired from the race. Green flag in sector 2.
Oh wow.
Incident in sector 1, yellow flag.
And the car is fucking bent to shit.
You've had a lot of air damage there, mate. Bodywork looks pretty fucked.
They're on your right, on your right.
Saw okay, that coming.
Son all clear bitch. On the right.
Watch your speed.
Clear on your right.
rear puncture. The pit crew is ready.
Car on your left. Clear left.
Pit crew, soft tires.
Speak more clearly, I can't hear you.
Pit stop, soft tires.
Acknowledged, we're going for soft tires.
Clear right.
Okay, Eric, the next car is grass. Should be coming out into clear air. When we leave the pits, we think we'll be in P9, a few seconds behind P9.
Left side, all clear on the left.
Coming up on a slower class car. Temperature's increasing. It's now
clear right.
15 minutes remaining. 15 minutes to go. Okay, Eric, double chances here. Let's make sure we can take them. Box in. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now. We're done. Go, go. Your exit is clear. Watch the white line. We've got cold brakes all round. We think Luck and Chen have stacked it. Green flag sector 1. Slow car ahead. There'll be no blue flag here. We're on the same lap. considered in sector 2, yellow flag. Looks like P2's off. Nice. Green flag, sector 2. Tenth position. To go. That's 10 minutes left. This is okay. Keep those exit speeds up. Overton behind is pitting.
Side.
Okay, Eric, there's a car exiting the pits. Heads up. Your lap time was 207.7. Keep gaining on the guy in front. The gap is 5.1. Incident in sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. Looks like Overton has crashed. Green flag, sector 3. The gap in front is now 4.1.
Car on your left. All clear on the left.
Okay, Eric. 5 minutes to go. 5 minutes left. Incident in sector 2. Sector 2 is yellow. Flag.
All right. Hold your line. All clear on the right.
You had some minor aero damage. Stay out. It's not that bad. Yellow flag. Caution. We think Maha has binned it. You got a right rear puncture.
What?
Chen is reeling you in. The gap's now 18 seconds. Incident in sector 3. Sector 3 is yellow. Flag in sector 3. P8. All right, Eric. Gaining on this car, the gap is 5.5. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes. Grass is pitting from position 10. We think he'll come out just behind you. Track temperature's decreasing. It's now 83 Fahrenheit. One more to go.
Oh, Ibby.
On your right. They're on your right.
Car parking, the S's.
P7, that's the end of the race. Never mind.
Poop. Well, thanks for watching, kids.